In a world dominated by plastic cards and internet currency, tokens are becoming more and more of an endangered species every day. Yet it seems almost unthinkable that not all that long ago, tokens were beyond ubiquitous. Their uses ranged from everything from transit to parking, from bathrooms to video games, and it's not unfair to say that tokens have a plethora of uses. Recently, I bought a Pachislo machine and I bought a 25-pound lot of tokens, hoping to get enough to play on my machine. Unfortunately, I had to replace them all with Pachislo-specific tokens, as the machine is very picky. I did sort through them, and I found a lot of variations of tokens and what they were used for, so for this series, I'm going to discuss various types of tokens and their uses. This week's episode, we will discuss Toys for Tots tokens. Founded in Los Angeles in 1947 by Major Bill Hendricks, Toys for Tots was founded when Hendricks' wife wanted to donate a doll to a charity at Christmas time but couldn't find a charity that would accept it. This eventually branched out into a number of various towns, all independently run by Marines. From those humble beginnings, Toys for Tots went on to be a national charity in 1991. And every year since then, Toys for Tots distributes toys to children whose families can't afford to purchase them. In 2016, it was announced in their entire history, Toys for Tots donated 512 million toys to needy kids across the nation. Like many other charities, Toys for Tots uses mail solicitation to get donations. Every year around Christmas, my family, like millions of others, gets letters for Toys for Tots asking for a donation, which we oblige. Included in the letter is a well-made token. I think these tokens are made from bronze, I'm not 100% sure, and the designs change from time to time. One design features the outline of a teddy bear head and the inscription, "Every child deserves a little Christmas." The second design features a Toys for Tots train logo, which also features the inscription, "Every child deserves a little Christmas." The reverse features the Marine Corps logo and the inscription, "United States Marine Corps Semper Fidel." A lot of people consider these tokens, but because they are technically military issued, they can also be considered as challenge coins. Okay, that's enough with the special tokens. For the final episode of the token-based series, we're going to be talking about generic tokens. I'm Dave Fireson. Leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next week.